In this video, we will show you how to complete an agricultural clearance order for H-2A temporary employment certification, also referred to as a 790-790A job order. Start by navigating to the top right-hand corner of the FLAG homepage and click Sign In to log into FLAG. First, you must begin by completing an H-2A agricultural clearance order. Under the New Application tab, find the H-2A Agricultural Clearance Order card and click Create New. Along the left-hand side of the screen, you will see a form stepper. The blue circle indicates which section you are in while filling out the form. The job order cover sheet asks you to provide employer name and contact information. Each form field displays a small question mark with a circle around it. This is called a tooltip. Tooltips provide detailed instructions of what to include in each field. If you are part of a network, you have the ability to populate this section by selecting an employer profile. Click the drop-down menu. Select the employer profile. Click Populate. For more information on networks, please refer to the My Network video. Once the information has been populated, click Continue. If there are any incomplete or incorrect fields in the application, the stepper will show an exclamation point with a triangle. Click on that section in the stepper and address the field. As you complete sections of the form, the icon next to the section name will be updated. The next section is called Preliminary Questions, where it asks you to provide the type of clearance order, type of employer, application, H-2A labor contractor, if you're submitting an emergency filing, and a question regarding herding or production of livestock. Note that in field 1, the type of clearance order 790A is already selected for you. Complete each of the fields within the section and click Continue. Section A asks you to provide job order information. Complete each of the fields within the section. Field A5 is a conditional field. If you select No, a gray box which includes field A6 and A7 will appear. This section requires you to enter the anticipated days and hours of work per week and the hourly work schedule. The total number of hours must be at least 35 hours per week, and each box must have an entry. For example, if the employees do not work on certain days, you must enter a zero. Field 88A asks you to provide a description of the specific services or labor to be performed. If you need more space, click the blue hyperlink, Add Addendum C, to add material terms and conditions of the job offer. Click Add Addendum C. The first drop-down box that includes the section item number and the category of the material term or condition has already been populated. Add the summary and the details of the material term condition. Click Save. Note that all Addendum C entries that you add as you complete the form will also be listed in the Addendum C section. Once all the fields have been completed, click Continue. Section B asks for the minimum job qualifications requirement. Complete each of the fields within the section. Field B4F is a conditional field. If you select this field, a gray box will appear. Fill out how much weight in pounds is the lifting requirement. Field B5A is a conditional field. If you select yes, a gray box will appear. Fill out the number of employees that the worker will supervise. Field B6 asks you to provide additional information regarding job qualifications requirements. If you need more space, click the blue hyperlink, Add Addendum C. Click Continue. Section C asks for the place of employment information. Complete each of the fields within the section. Field C7 is a conditional field. If you select yes, you will need to complete Addendum B that identifies all additional places of employment. Once all the fields have been completed, click Continue. Section D asks for the housing information. Complete each of the fields within the section. Field D11 is a conditional field. If you select yes, you will have to complete Addendum B that provides additional information on housing. Once all the fields have been completed, click Continue. Section EF asks for the provision of meals and transportation. Complete each of the fields within the section. Field E1 asks you to provide a description of how the employer will provide each worker with 3 meals per day or furnish free and convenient cooking and kitchen facilities. If you need more space, click the blue hyperlink, Add Addendum C. Field F1 asks you to provide a description of the terms and arrangement for daily transportation the employer will provide to the workers. If you need more space, click the blue hyperlink, Add Addendum C. Field F2 asks you to provide a description of the terms and arrangements for providing workers with transportation. If you need more space, click the blue hyperlink, Add Addendum C. Once all the fields have been completed, click Continue. Section G asks for the referral and hiring instructions. Complete each of the fields within the sections. Field G1 asks you to provide a description of how prospective applicants may be considered for employment under this job order. If you need more space, click the blue hyperlink, Add Addendum C. Fields G2 through G4 require you to complete 2 out of the 3 entries. Once completed, click Continue. Section I asks you to read the conditions of employment and assurances. Field I5 asks you to upload a copy of your signature as an image file. Click the blue hyperlink Browse to search for a file to upload. Once completed, click Continue. Addendum A asks for you to use the table to enter details about each crop. Click Add Addendum A. Under Actions, click Edit or Remove to modify the crops and agricultural activities. Click Continue. Depending on your selection in Section C, Addendum B, Additional Place of Employment Information, may be required. Click Add Addendum B. Fill out the necessary fields. Click Save. Click Edit to update the information or remove the additional place of employment. Click Continue. Depending on your selection in Section D, Addendum B, Additional Housing Locations, may be required. Click Add Addendum B. Fill out the information. Click Save. Click Continue. Addendum C, Material Terms and Conditions of the Job Offer, will show you a table listing the addendums that were added while filling out the form. You have the option to add more addendums by clicking the blue hyperlink, Add Addendum C. Click the ellipsis under Actions to edit or remove an addendum. Click Continue. State Workforce Agency selection is dependent on questions 4 and 5 in the Preliminary Questions section. Choose a State Workforce Agency state from the dropdown and click Continue. The Review and Submit section is the last step in the application. The form stepper on the left-hand side of the screen will show what sections need to be revisited as they may have incorrect or unfilled information. Click Submit. A confirmation email with your case number will be sent to your email address. To return to flag, click Return to Dashboard.